Hey everyone, my name is Nick Shalom, the former Chief Software Officer for the Air Force and Space Force. In our last video, hopefully we did a decent job at explaining why Kubernetes matters. We talk about the vast benefits, including resiliency, abstraction, adaptability, automation with GitOps, self-healing, and much more. That enables you to move at a pace of relevance. If you miss a video, check it out here. Now, I'm going to try to make a case today that's going to get me into some hot waters, okay? So bear with me. I believe you must use Kubernetes, even if you think it is overkill for your organization. So before you crucify me, please watch the video and ensure you get my thoughts first and comments below what your thoughts are. Now, if you're trying to compete in our modern days and you want to enable your organization to innovate, you cannot do this in a vacuum. You cannot do this at the detriment also of proper baked-in security. But modern cyber posture is a moving target. No pun intended. In fact, one of the pillars of modern cyber posture is moving target defense. Leveraging Kubernetes as a uniform orchestration stack will remove impediment and accelerate your implementation of cyber capabilities, but more importantly, jumpstart your zero trust implementation and enable your continuous monitoring with prevention enforcement in runtime. The fact is, teams struggle to find the balance between cybersecurity and software innovation. The Air Force recently made a configuration change which led the cyber teams to push new cybersecurity controls at the expense of user experience. That killed the innovation momentum of dozens of teams until it was reverted. It's always a balancing act for that to work, but you also must be able to react to 0 days in a timely fashion, right? So I will show you today that by orchestrating your crown jewel and critical workload on Kubernetes, you will be able to find that balance. So let's look at some of the key aspects and key benefits in cybersecurity as to why you must use Kubernetes. First of all, thanks to a service mesh on top of Kubernetes, you can implement a distributed zero trust enforcement point using sidecar containers and enable mutual TLS traffic enforcement with whitelist to limit your east-west traffic. With your ingress controller, you can also control your ingress and egress and prevent exfiltration of data, as well as control the whitelisting of your internet-facing traffic. More importantly, as Kubernetes as your uniform orchestration stack, you can bring a cohesive cybersecurity stack and enable tracing, centralized logs and telemetry, so you can push those to your SIEM and SOLs. Using the Kubernetes emission controller, you can control which container run on your stack, check their provenance, which registry they're coming from, whether they're hardened or not, their signatures and integrity with checksums. You can ensure that software bill of material, SBOM, are present, as well as leveraging continuous security runtime to continuously scan for CVEs and for behavior drift as well. Let's take the example of a recent critical vulnerability with Log4j. You can leverage Kubernetes to assess which container are running on your stack. That alone gives you a full picture of your software assets. That's a necessary foundation for any cyber defense posture. Now that you know what's running on your Kubernetes clusters, with that information, you can find containers using Java, which containers are using Log4j, and use Kubernetes to inject hot patches inside of these containers without having to coordinate with each of the development teams. The concept of a sidecar container enabled by Kubernetes enables you to decouple your cyber teams from your development teams. The same cyber teams can push policy as code rules to mitigate 0 days that potentially have no patch with basic ingress and egress layer 7 rules. By using a cohesive Kubernetes orchestration stack, you also streamline your continuous delivery stack using GitOps at scale, leveraging open source tools like Flux, which pulls continuously from Git to enforce your desired state, minimizing drift across environments. It enables you to treat your entire infrastructure as cattle. That includes your Kubernetes layer and nodes to increase your cyber posture. If you did not use a cohesive Kubernetes orchestration stack and you were using different capabilities, including serverless or other orchestration stack, you would have to create massive duplication of work to enforce the same cyber benefits and controls across all these deployments. I argue today that the benefits of the flexibility brought to you by having different orchestration stacks do not outweigh the benefits on the cyber side of leveraging Kubernetes across your enterprise. You know already how painful and difficult it is for your organization to move to modern cyber best practices. Do you think it will make it easier for you to have to worry about different orchestration systems? And quite honestly, you can run serverless on Kubernetes, just use Knative. Kubernetes is already being adopted by most of the Fortune 500, including the Department of Defense, the US government, and many governments all over the world. Kubernetes, thanks to a service mesh, will be able to give you in real time the east-west traffic, north-south traffic of your system. Go try to do this with something else. It will be very difficult. Most organizations struggle to get there. API discovery, tracing, centralized logs and telemetry, implementing zero trust. All these critical components are enabled, accelerated through Kubernetes alone. You will not find a better investment of time and money to train and equip your teams to finally understand the importance of Kubernetes. So to summarize, Kubernetes enables you to check all of the cyber boxes: zero trust, software bill of material, continuous monitoring, centralized logs and telemetry, real-time understanding of your assets, real-time control of your assets, provenance, and integrity. With that, if that doesn't convince you, I don't know what will. I hope I've made my case today. If not, please put your thoughts in the comment section below. Thanks so much for watching, and please subscribe. Click on that little bell so you're notified of our next videos, and see you on the next video.